till you play me the song that will make me belong to you. One dance with my baby tonight, and we'll dance till the night is through.
What you gonna do?
I used to be so ready to run. My philosophy, don't let nobody come too close to handle my love. Don't let it show. I want it to be you. Ooh, diving into my ocean, a brand new emotion come true.
Hey guys, good afternoon, welcome on board, welcome to London, welcome to another stream. We're going to be doing some HEMS action today in the fantastic CowanSim Bell 222 helicopter. I have my own private version of it, my Scottish Air Ambulance swag. I even got my own name on the side of the goddamn aircraft. Shout out to my main man Cutlass, who sorted that out for me. Thank you so much, brother. Thanks to my main man Rusty C from the Captain's Club on YouTube, who's just joined us. Welcome on board, sir. Good to see you. Hello to Ross, Matt, Shay, Chris, and Braven. Shifty's joined us. Hey, Shifty, good to see you, brother. Welcome on board, my friend. Gomez has joined us. Captain Tibbs is back on Twitch as well. And Alexis is here on Twitch. Welcome along, guys. Just going to be maybe a 1 or 2 hour session. We'll see how we get on. We just had word coming in, guys, that we're responding to a young child who has collapsed at home. So we're going to be heading to West London, somewhere just south of Reading, to this incident. A young boy has collapsed at home and suffered a cardiac arrest. He was then resuscitated by a neighbour and is being stabilised by first responders. A road ambulance is on his way, however, the on-scene paramedics are very worried about the boy's heart, which is showing signs of arrhythmia. Who writes this stuff? This is fantastic. They would like him to be airlifted to hospital as soon as possible before he has another cardiac episode. We need to find this incident scene quickly and get moving. Roger that. So we'll hit start We have 5 minutes to get the engine up and running, and then we should have about 30 minute flight time there. We do have to go past Heathrow Airport, so we're going to have to check in with Heathrow Director and get some clearance to dodge around the zone. We'll be taking the helimed lanes out, sorry, the helicopter lanes out. We'll be routing initially westbound on Hotel 4. We'll be joining Hotel 3 at Barnes, and we'll follow Hotel 3 all the way to the exit point just west of the M3 near Bagshot at the Bagshot VRP. So glad to have you on board with us, guys. Welcome. Right, let's get in the aircraft and start pressing some buttons, start shooting McTuin. So the first thing we need to do is make sure that the rotor brake is off, and it's off. We'll get the battery on. Battery is on. Check the master warning panel lights up. Clear the master warning. Check the fuel level on the aircraft. I usually always forget to top the fuel up before I go. So I'll go ahead and set the fuel to 100% now. Boom. Alright, fuel is looking good. Master warning has been reset. Next thing we'll do is we'll turn on the seatbelt, cabin light, and no smoking signs. We'll go ahead and get the anti-collision and position light on as well. We'll take the hydraulics now for one and two. Turn the fuel valve on for engine one with a fuel primer. And we're ready to start engine number one. Clear on the left, clear on the right. Go ahead and hit the starter for one. Hey Valentin, welcome. Razor Raid's back, welcome back my friend. Cutlass made you a livery as well, Rusty. Nice brother, he's a good guy. Him and if you watch on Twitch, Rusty, make sure you follow a guy, Cutlass, and also Shifty Mover. Both very nice gentlemen. Really good energy those two guys have. Nice friendly streamers, not aggressive narcissists like me. Alright, we have 10% on one. Go ahead and introduce a little bit of fuel. Stable at 40%. Go ahead and take idle stop on one. Fuel primer can come off.
Civil 816, climb flight level 150.
Climb level 150, Civil 816.
Golf Alpha Mamba Zulu Foxtrot, all of Heathrow's going to be closing shortly, so you can continue unit common
okay,
1 to 2
for one. The generator on for 1, sounds like he's closing.
Okay, I'm assuming.
Make sure the force trim is on. Alright, engine 1 is stable, we've got the fuel primer off, take the fuel valve on for 2. That fuel primer on for 2, and we'll take the starter now. And again, we're looking for 10% now of NG on 2. Okay, we have it. Take a little bit of throttle in. Hey, Merrick's joined us on Twitch as well. Welcome, big dog. Hello to William Morris. Hello to Bogan, Reaper, the Aviator, Callum Russ. Would you ever fly the actual London Air Ambulance for a stream instead of the Scottish one? Love the look of the London one. I do have the MD-902, brother, but it's from X-Plane 10. It's not from X-Plane 11. So I've not really been in too much of a hurry to try it. I might check out this weekend if I get time, though. My 44% stable, idle stop. Primer can come off. Make sure we're squawking conspicuity. Transponder is on. Squawk mode Charlie checked. Make sure we've got our medical interior. Just came on Maverick, you probably already know that because you're a goddamn professional. Thanks brother, so he did. 132.7, thanks Merrick. You're always there for me bro. 132.7. Okay, we have 1001. Got a low pressure day today in London. That'd be quite reasonable, I imagine, in real life. But it looks not too bad at all. Alright, let's just quickly make sure, in fact, that I get the generator and the inverter on for 2. The generator on for 2. We don't need to peel the is the fuel primers are off, inverters are both on, generators are both on. Get some lights up in here. We just need to get the rotor RPM up in the green and then we're ready to go. 132.7, 132.7 we have set. Right, let's check in with temps. Temps radar, good afternoon, Helimed 27
Alpha. Message.
Director, hello again, sir. Element 27 Alpha. We're a Bell 222 with you on the helipad at the Royal London Hospital. We're responding to an Alpha call just south of Reading. We'd like to enter controlled airspace westbound on Hotel 4, routing for Hotel 3, leaving controlled airspace at Bagshot with a basic service. We have 1001. Hey, Meredith's joined us. Good morning, sister.
Director Roger, clear to enter the city London control zone, routing westbound on Hotel 4, Hotel 3, and clear to leave via Bagshot. London QNH 1000, squawk 0017.
Westbound on Hotel 4 for Hotel 3, leaving at Bagshot, the new QNH 1000, and the squawk 0017 for Helimed 27 Alpha.
Helimed 27 Alpha, read back correct.
Approach 345, if you can't hit flight level 160, descending for 120 level in Lynn, a bit late though. Costing, hello. RPMs building. We are squawking with Charlie. T's and B's are all good. We'll take 102% for the Category Alpha departure here.
Apologies, all stations, 10 directors back online after a scope crash.
Okay, the wind is 250 with 5 knots.
Alright, 10 direct then, speed 455, passing 150 for 120 level 19.
Speedbird 455, attempts director, hello, veteran for Britain landing runway 27, information is Alpha, descend flight level 100 to be leveled by Jacko.
100 to be leveled by Jacko,
speed 455. Okay, power's good, engine RPM is good, let's come back and rate.
Speedbird 455, cleared LAVNO 1 Juliet transition.
LAVNO Juliet transition,
speed 455. So I think the game might be a little bit too loud, guys. Hey, Captain Henry's joined us from California. Welcome on board, sir. Very early for you. All right, stick forward, pedal left. Stick left. Collective off. Gear up, please. We are through ETL, engine up. Board RPM, sorry, coming back to 100%. Start trimming, start winning. I'm just going to sort the game volume out, guys. I know it's a bit too loud. Stand by. Your piss all over the place. Director Element 27 Alpha, we are airborne routing westbound now on Hotel 4.
Element 27 Alpha, Roger, identified.
Hey, SFX. My mic volume is low, Roger that. Should be a bit better now that I've turned the game volume down, guys, is that okay? Right, trim, sort of okay. Hey, Avnish, hello to Paul as well, and my man Alf, Ale, sorry, from Israel. Welcome on board, sir. What's up, pilot, pillow pilot? says he's laughing out loud. You're Speedbird 455. That's not really that funny, bro. But welcome to the stream, sir. Good to see you. Avni says, are you planning to do a tutorial for the Bell 22? Couldn't find a decent one on YouTube. Eh, there's quite some. There's a few tutorials, bro, on how to start the aircraft up. Hey, Joel, welcome on board. My man Giraffe's in here as well. Welcome. Where can you find the helicopter routes? On the NATS website, my friend. Oh, we have 40 minutes to make it there. We're responding to a child that has collapsed at home and suffered a cardiac arrest. So unfortunately, a young boy or girl has collapsed at home. They've been resuscitated by a neighbour.
Am I passing through you to go to London? Northern 112, just confirm you're inbound to Heathrow.
Heathrow is correct.
Northern 112, roger, I don't cover Heathrow, so monitoring the government 22 display. Have a good afternoon.
Thank you.
Right, just passing over Chelsea Bridge.
Speedbird 455, descend front of Lake
Zurich. Oh, that's Pilot Pillow Pilot. That's that little guy on the stream. Good to see you. Good to hear from you. Hey, Moses, welcome. Yeah, I just got back from the gym. Thought I would do a little stream before I go to work. It's only 1 o'clock in the afternoon here.
Speedbird 455, after Bap.
Hey Carl, good morning to you, sir. Welcome on board. Another member of the Captain's Club's joined us on YouTube. I got my man Moses and my man Carl Hughes in here. Welcome on board, gentlemen. Young Pillow Pilot has landed at London City. Nice, brother. Weather's quite agreeable. Should be a nice approach for you. No, Chris, all the gyms in Scotland are shut, bro. I go to a private gym, though. I'm a VIP. Merrick says, I'm going to come and stream snake you, Mav. We make be a cheeky and ask for a London City Transit. What are you flying? You flying or are you controlling, Merrick? What are you doing, brother? Hey Dave, you're goddamn right, sir. Lear Giraffe says, do you need special permission to play ambulance on VATSIM? No, you don't get any special treatment, dude. You're basically classed as a regular VFR helicopter. Okay, that's Barnes down there, so we're leaving Hotel 4 for Hotel 3. Thames Director Helimed 27 Alpha, Barnes for Hotel 3. Alright, so we're now heading to Teddington. Teddington!
After Babku, Rudrick, Rafsa.
Yeah, Roger, so it's 455.
Well, I'll get some autopilots in here to help a brother out. As we head down to Teddington! Dave on Twitch says, flew a chopper yesterday to Gatwick on their Midweek Madness event. Boy, were they busy. Yeah, Midweek Madness is always a bit mental on Gatwick. It's always a very popular event.
Golf uniform, Mike, myself, the Mexico conspicuity, free.
So we're on our way to Teddington at the moment. From Teddington, we'll be routing to the Sunbury Lock. What's up, Braven? Mav popping out daily streams. I do my best, bro. I do my best. What's up, Hawk? Welcome back, sir. It is a little bit windy up north, legendary. It's windy in Scotland today, but The weather down here is not too bad. The winds at the moment where we are 270 at 13 knots. Here's Teddington here.
Say again, please.
So I'll show you where we're going, just south of Reading. Here's Reading out here. We're responding to an incident somewhere to the south of Reading, somewhere around about here it is. Unfortunately, a young child has collapsed at home. Hey, Zorio. You just here to eat lunch and then you got to go again. Roger that, big dog. Hope you enjoy your lunch. I am fucking starving. I cannot wait until my 18 hours are up and I can have something to eat. Okay, over Teddington, we're now going to start heading for the Sunbury Lock, which is just a little cheeky right-hand turn. So we basically go over the Sunbury Lock, which is just on our left, and then we follow this river round up and then towards Ascot, and then south. So the Sunbury is just on our left, there's a Sunbury Lock there. And then we keep going down and we've, like I said, follow this river round. The river should be on our left-hand side. Here it's here.
455
So this should wind up to the right. So we basically just follow this along until we get to Thorpe. And then Thorpe, we start turning left again and start heading down towards the Bagshot VRP. Hey, Mr. Squidgen's back. Good to see you, brother.
Speedbed 455, just confirm where you're going.
Meredy says it is minus 9 outside.
Speedbed 455.
It was minus 9 here last week, but it's very warm this week. It's like plus 9 now. Where Thorpe is on the map. It should be about here somewhere. Yeah, that's right there. Alright, 32 minutes to make it to the incident.
Helimed 29, request direct VFR to London West on helicopter base.
How long can this bird stay in the air, cruising speed at good conditions? Yeah, about 2 hours, says Shifty. Around about 2 hours, my friend. Doesn't have the biggest fuel tanks in the world.
November 6693 Charlie, temps director, hello, veteran for an ILS structure, runway 27, information Bravo, report your aircraft type.
SL 22, back to LS 27, info Bravo, we'll get that one. November 6693 Charlie.
November 93 Charlie, roger, turn right heading 090 degrees.
Right, to 090 degrees, and just contact the accurate base, 093 Charlie.
So we're getting to Fort, which is up at this junction here, and then we're from there, we're going down to Bagshot, which is just here. Sleddy Mercury or Robert Burns. Yeah, so that made my day seeing that. Gritty Spears, that's what we need. We need Gritty Spears and fucking Salt Disney. Gritty Spears is probably my favourite one.
Helimed 29, would like to route to the southwest to London Heliport Base, please. London Westland Heliport Base.
This kid's already said that.
Roger, clear to enter the London control zone, routing westbound Hotel 4 to London Heliport. Not above aggression, squawk will be.
Oh, that was the controller, that was on his end.
Roger, QNH 1000 being cleared into the London control zone, routing west.
Hey, Andrew, welcome. I'm using Orbix, Chris, Orbix. It's not really a colleague, Dave. It's more of a stalker, bro. More of a stalker, dude. Whenever I fly, anywhere where I fly now, I always get fucking kids following me around the place. Auxiliary fuel tank is armed. We shouldn't need it, but it's armed. Merrick says that's a BA virtual pause rep, so he's obviously at cruise and just thought he'd log on for a little bit of Thames. Nice, Merrick. I thought it was a fucking alarm in the aircraft. I don't know, Chris. I've never used Orfo. I've never used it. Hello, Batmaster. Welcome on board, sir. Transport Fan on YouTube says, how do you coordinate with other air ambulances when there's one in Royal London? Well, usually there's never really another one, dude. You would just have to wait. See? Hey, it was there. It's Gatwick Towers, actually, the guy doing Thames radar. So, he is flying right now. Are you streaming, brother? Hey, Bruno. It is a little... The weather is nice and calm today, brother, yeah. I don't think I have St. George's Hospital, Callum. No, where is it? Where about in London is it, my friend?
Speed 455, slow down,
Roger.
Hold line, sir.
Speed
455,
AFM speed 160
knots,
so greater, maintain until
40. Right, we need to bring the aircraft up a little bit because the ground's coming up towards us. Thames Director, Helimed 27 Alpha, we're leaving Bagshot for Reading. We'd like a basic service.
Helimed 27, Roger, leave controlled airspace in 1 mile, basic service, QNH 1000.
Basic service 1000, Helimed 27 Alpha.
Apologies,
Hey Shannon, thanks my man. Actually, I think Shannon's a young lady's name. Are you a young lady or a young man, Shannon? Gaelic isn't streaming, no. Just heard a death of me, so I was like, dude, I thought it was the fucking... I looked up to check the to see if something was wrong. Beric on YouTube says, are you a young lady or the Irish FIR? That's an insider joke. Thames Director, Helimed 27 Alpha, can we QSY to Unicorn or would you like us to remain on frequency? Conspicuity, we'll speak to you on the way back. Thanks, Helimed 27 Alpha. Bye bye.
Speedbird 455, surface winds.
This is true Earth miles, yeah. This is the Orbix true Earth scenery. It's very good. I'll be back in a momento, guys. Uno momento, por favor. I will be right back. I struggle with conspicuity sometimes as well, Dave. Dave on Twitch says, I get completely tongue-tied, so I just reply, squawk VFR. Yeah, it's a little bit of a tricky one. Conspicuity. It's a little bit of a tricky one. Mr. Laveau on YouTube asks, do you prefer the Bell 222 or the Augusta 139? Probably the Bell 222, dude. The Augusta 139 is a fantastic aircraft. It's one of my favourite aircraft in real life, but it's actually quite buggy in the X-plane. The autopilot, I certainly can't get the autopilot to work right. There's quite a lot of bugs with the aircraft as well, so. Slow Reader on YouTube asks, have I ever been interested in becoming a helicopter pilot in real life? Yes, it would actually be my dream job would be to be a rescue helicopter pilot, a HEMS pilot. But it's just too expensive, dude. It's ridiculously expensive to get to the level where you can apply for jobs as a HEMS pilot. You're talking way north of £100,000. Avnish is reminded when he flew in a H-125 along the Himalayan valleys. Nice, brother. Sounds like a magical trip. Alright, this incident should be somewhere on our right-hand side coming up, guys. Keep your eyes peeled. We've been told that emergency services are already on scene, so we're looking for ambulances and stuff. Should be somewhere in this housing estate on the right-hand side. Flown past it. Somewhere over there. Oh, I see it. There, it's right there, guys. Look. All right, what's the wind doing? The wind is 250-11 knots, so we're going to come down. We're going to do one or two orbits around the LZ, just to have a look for any obstacles and high-tension power lines, cables, poles, trees, fucking wildlife, rockets, starships. Gear down. And then we'll come in from this angle. We'll approach from the eastern side, put the nose into wind and crab on in there. The gear is down, we'll take the rotor RPM up to 102%. Checked. Trim reset. Looks like there's loads of room to land on this side in this grass field right next to the ambulance, so that'll be what we're doing. We'll be coming in over these buildings. No high tension power lines running across, which is good. Alright, LZ looks reasonably clear. This should be pretty straightforward. Okay, power is good, engine RPM is set to 102%, the gear is down. Trim has been reset. We're just looking to work the nose into wind now, start really slowing the aircraft down here. Okay, the nose is into wind here. I'm going to start crabbing the aircraft to the right. Keep the nose into wind and just start drifting the aircraft to the right hand side. Careful with the VRS envelope as we approach it. Power's good, engine RPM's good, the rotor RPM is good, the gear is down, 3 grains, I see it. See the trees on the right, see the building in front. Careful with the VRS. Get too close. Get ready to stabilize any ground effect. And stabilize. And land. Three, two, one. Touching down. Okay, nose wheel is down. Gently lower the collective, center the cyclic and the pedals. We are on the ground. Hey, Big Trains, welcome on board. Hey, what's up, Fearless, you fucking buster? Good to see you, big dog. Welcome on board. The wind beneath my wings. Hope you guys had fun last night. Sorry I couldn't stick around. Yesterday was my first day back on the cardio train, so I was pretty fucking tired pretty early on. I went to bed a little bit earlier. Well, that seems to have totally killed the engine there, which I didn't really want to do, but never mind. Right, we should have the patient on board now. Okay, the patient and his father are on board. The boy is currently sedated, so go as fast as you can before his heart gives up again. We are ready to lift right now, pilot. We have 43 minutes to make it back. Fuel primer on. Take this starter again for one. Right, 10% we have, bringing a little bit of throttle. G is building. We're looking for it to stabilise at 44%. 40% we have. And there's 44. We'll go to idle stop on 1. Hey, my main man, Captain Adam Smith is back in here. Good to see you, brother. Welcome. Hey, Gatwick Tower says, sorry, man, I've got a head off Thames. No worries at all, brother. It was good to have a little bit of service on the way out. Thanks, man. Hope you have a good, safe landing when you get to wherever you're going. All right, 1 is up. Fuel primer off. Take the fuel primer on for 2 now. Starter, go. Take the inverter for 1, generator for 1. We're looking for 10% on 2. We have it. Here comes a little bit of throttle. We're Helimed 27 Alpha, Alexander. Well, we're Helimed 27. Alright, we can go to idle stop on 2. Alright, 2 is up. Inverter on, generator on for 2. We'll take the fuel primer off. Alright, both engines are up and stable. We'll go ahead now and bring the rotor RPM up to 100%. Master warning's cleared. Alright, nothing behind us on the left hand side, so we'll be coming out Category Alpha departure back and left. Rotor RPM is settling at 100%. We'll go ahead and take it up to 102% for the Category Alpha departure. 102% is checked. We are clear on the left, we're clear on the right. The trim has been reset. We are ready to go. So, first thing we'll do is bring the nose wheel up into the air. Nose wheels up, not too much, just a little bit. And then we'll bring the right wheel off the ground first and stabilise into ground effect. We're up. Stabilise. Check the nose into wind. And then we're coming back and left. Power's good, rotor RPM is good. Alright, we're going to transition to the left hand side, so while we're doing this backward trend here, we're going to take a little bit of collective off now. Stick forward, pedal left. Stick forward, a little bit more collective off, gear up. And we are flying away. We're through ETL. Rotor RPM can come back to 100% now. That is checked. Start trimming, start winning. Alright, we're looking to climb up above 500R. And then we'll settle into cruise. 450 feet. Here comes 500. 500R. We'll go just a little bit higher. Alright, gears up, rotor RPM set back to 100%. We are flying away. A little bit of altitude, then we'll get the autopilot in. Alright, I'll take an autopilot in here. Set the heading indicator on the HSI, and we'll take heading mode on the autopilot as well. Set. Oh shit. No, I didn't. No, I did not, sir. Inverter and generator are on, brother. Yeah, Fearless, we've got the new Scottish Air Ambulance livery. Also got my name on it, bro. There is a Category B departure, Dave. Yeah, that's when the aircraft takes off and then immediately starts going into forward flight, transitions through ETL, and then starts climbing up. So Category Alpha is when helicopters depart from confined spaces, or there's a lot of, or areas where there's a lot of obstacles around. You don't have to go to the side, you can just take off and come straight back. That's also a Category Alpha departure. It's designed so that if there is an engine failure on the aircraft, you can auto-rotate back into where you took off from. A Category Bravo departure, like I said, is when we bring the aircraft up into the air, we stabilise into ground effect, and then we start transitioning straight away into forward flight. We get the aircraft through ETL, which is normally about 40 or 50 knots, and then we start climbing up. Hey, Captain Spitfire's back. Good to see you, brother. What's up, Real Sim Pilot? Welcome aboard, sir. Good to see you, my friend. I went a little bit low. We start climbing a little bit here. Alright, ATC wise, it's just Gatwick Director that's on around us at the moment, so we don't need to check in with him. Or her. I don't want to get me too'd. Alright, heading back down to London town. Oh, nice. Merrick says, Mav, guess what's just arrived? Is your Maverick merch just arrived, bro? You ordered the what are my notes? The Maverick notepad, bro. That's just arrived. Nice. Bro, take a fucking picture of it and send it to me on Discord, dude. Post it in my Discord. P-Basque on Twitch says, what is ETL? ETL stands for Effective Transitional Lift. And that is when the airflow over the disc, the rotor disc, is generating additional lift for the aircraft. Alright, coming for bag shot, need to come heavy left here. Just arriving over the bag shot VRP, that is there on our left hand side, just here. We're now routing towards up to Thorp again. And from Thorp, we'll be routing to the Sunbury Lock, then to Teddington, then to Barnes. We'll join Hotel 4 at Barnes. Is Gatwick Tower on? Sorry, Heathrow Tower is not online. Good morning, Michael. I live the dream every day, Spitfire. Thanks, brother. Just got back from the gym and I wasn't going to bother streaming. I thought. But then I was like, yeah, you know what? Fuck it. Let's do a little hem stream. So I set an alarm on my phone for when I need to start making some food. So I got about another hour and 15 minutes before I have to go. Then I'm heading out on the roads trucking. Hayden says, Maverick on YouTube. I hope one day someone sees your streams and hits you with a helicopter scholarship. You deserve it. I'm not sure how true that is, sir. But that would be cool. Just a quick reminder, guys, we do this to help raise money for charity. So I designed this mod that we're using, the UK Air Ambulance mod. I designed it to help raise as much money as we can for charity through the website charityscenery.co.uk. So if you are enjoying the show and you feel like being generous, get yourself over to charityscenery.co.uk. There's lots of helicopter scenery that you can buy there for X-Plane 11 and also for Prepared as well. We also have scenery for the Prepared simulator. But even if you don't want to buy some add-on scenery, you can just head over there and maybe chuck a donation our way, guys. I don't make any money from it. No one makes any profit from it, guys. All the money goes to charity. Traffic. All the money that we raise goes directly to air ambulance charities in the United Kingdom, guys, wherever the scenery is from. So if you're buying helicopter scenery in London, all the proceeds there goes to the London Air Ambulance. If you're buying... What the fuck? You guys see that guy just disappear, yeah? So yeah, make sure you check it out, guys. charityscenery.co.uk. We're doing good things. I'm not sure, Barney. I'm not sure. I just know that it works in Prepared, brother. I'm not sure if it's specific to a certain version. We do have a Discord group that you can join and ask. I am a member of the charityscenery.co.uk team, but I'm not a technical guy, bro, and I don't own Prepared, so sorry, my friend. I can't answer that. But so far, we've raised hundreds of pounds with this charity mod. So if you don't know what it is, it's a plugin for X-Plane called the Helicopter Rescue Mod. And it comes with about six or ten different rescue missions that you can do. So what I did is I spent a week of my life basically building a modified version of it called the UK Air Ambulance Mod. I got some great help from people in the community. Shout out to my main man Cutlass72 and also a guy called Chimera from Sweden. Those guys helped me with reskinning like ambulances and fire engines and police cars and stuff like that. And I built sort of like 40 or 50 different missions that you can go to. So yeah, it's definitely worthwhile, guys. If you're enjoying this and you think you would like to try it out, get yourself onto the charityscenery.co.uk website and you can buy this mod. It is payware, but it only costs you £1. Or I mean, you can donate more if you want to. But the price for it's like £1 or $1. And like I said, all the money goes to air ambulance charities in the United Kingdom. So you'll be helping save lives on your computer, guys, and you're helping save lives in real life as well. What's up, Jack B? I often lurk at your streams, but I've been loving the UCAM in the past few days buzzing around Cornwall and the south of west of England. The charity scenery products are really great cause. Thank you so much for your support, Jack. Hope you have as much fun as I do, sir. I tend to really mainly fly in London only because this is where all the air traffic control is. It's also more challenging to fly around in London. But thank you so much for buying the UCAM mod, Jack. Huge appreciate your support, brother. I'm a truck driver, Basque. Do you know that the Scottish Air Ambulance is the only fully funded government air ambulance in the UK, says Calum. I did not know that, bro. We donate money to the SCA ambulance, the Scottish Charity Air Ambulance. So I know that the one that we're flying right now, we're flying the Scottish Air Ambulance right now, which is a government one. But we donate, the Charity Scenery website team, we donate money to the Scottish Charity Air Ambulance. Heathrow on the left. Looks like somebody coming out of land. Traffic. Company! Hey, Uncle Bob, good afternoon. This guy's landing long as fuck, bro. This guy really should be on the ground by now, dude. Oh, sorry, no, it's just the perspective. This guy's okay. I see Concord down there. I see Bob, Golf, Bravo, Oscar, Alpha, Bravo. So this guy's doing all right. I thought he was landing on the other runway. I thought he was landing on 27 right, but he's coming in on 27 left. I can see spoilers out already, dude. Touching down. Welcome to London Heathrow, sir. Alright, this Hotel 4 in front of us. Captain Spitfire says, you know the HRM mod that you sell, do I need to download the free? Yes, you need. So you download the free version, and then you download our payware version, which basically increases the amount of missions that you have, from about 10 missions up to about 50 missions. So the full install instructions are all included on there, Spitfire. Jack says, I like flying around in Cornwall as that's where I live, so it's cool flying around here, as you know. Yeah, I'm the same, dude. I like flying around about Scotland as well, but like I said, the main reason why I come down to London so often is because this is where all the air traffic control normally is during the day. We don't get a lot of ATC in Scotland, sadly. VATSIM UK don't really do a good job at training a lot of controllers, so really if you want ATC you really have to come to somewhere in the London area where all the controllers are. There is the London heliport just down on our right hand side. I've overbanked the aircraft, Pastor's not going to like that. That's also scenery you can buy from the website, guys, the London heliport. If you ever fancy doing some VFR helicopter flying in London, check that out. Oh, I still have a patient comfort score of 40 out of 40. Nice. I hate football, Born Slippy. I absolutely fucking hate it, dude. So no, I am not a footballing man. Reaper lives near the Vanguard heliport, but I hardly ever see any helicopters use it. Roger. Where is that? That name rings a bell. I think we sell that as well. I'm not sure, though. Don't quote me on it. Alright, we're just passing over Chelsea... Well, just passed over Chelsea Bridge. We're now about to pass over Vauxhall Bridge. Houses of Parliament are coming up on the left-hand side. Jack says, yeah, it's the same down here. London West is a very rare. So, yeah, if VAT UK did a fucking better job at training controllers, we might have some more controllers up and down the country, but they're about as fast as a week in the jail. Okay, the winds are 250 at 15 knots. A little blustery. Still have a patient comfort score of 40 out of 40. Try and slow the aircraft down and transition into a hover without losing any comfort scores. See how this goes. So first thing we do when we start taking collective off, we start trimming the nose up so that the aircraft doesn't start descending. We want to lose airspeed, not altitude at this stage. We take the gear down through 100 knots. Still 40 out of 40. Just coming up for Tower Bridge. 100 knots gear down. As the aircraft gets slower, we're going to need to keep trimming those up. Alright, we're down below 90 knots now, so we'll take the rotor RPM to 102%. checked. We're going to approach from the east side. There's the Royal London Hospital on our left. So I don't really want to lose too much altitude here. I want to just continue to slow the aircraft down. The gear is down. The rotor RPM is selected to 102%. Just waiting on getting that trim reset in. Go for the trim reset now. Trim reset has been done. Still, we lost 1 point. Patient comfort score is now 39 out of 40, but that's okay. Alright, going to keep this left pedal just gently in. Keep the aircraft rotating around the left-hand side. I'm looking to get the nose into wind at 250. I want to go slightly past the hospital. 50 knots. We're about to decelerate through ETL. We'll start descending a little bit now. Keep the left pedal in. Right, this heading's 300, so the wind is coming 50 degrees to the left. Keep the pedal coming round. Good forward trend. Engine power's good, rotor RPM is good. Okay, we have the nose into wind now. Start working on that rate of descent. Good visual on the pad, gear is down, three greens, I see it. Power's good, rotor RPM's good, speed's good, rate of descent's good. We're a little tiny bit fast actually at the moment, I'll start dialing that off now. Start a transition from left pedal to right pedal now. Three greens. Good forward trend. Power's good. Start to square up on the pad. Stabilise any ground effect. Stabilise. Don't go too far forward. Land the aircraft. Touching down. Right, nose wheels down, on the brakes, gently lower the collective, center the cyclic and the pedals. Alright, that was good, first one's done. Ooh. Now that's how you do it. Well done, pilot. What a fantastic job. Well, thank you very much. The boy is on his way straight to the intensive care unit and could not be in better hands. His father could not stop saying thank you all the way to the hospital. He knows you've just saved his son's life by getting him here so quickly. Total points, 69 out of 100. We landed with a patient comfort score of 39 out of 40. Happy with that. Right, let's see if we can get another one up here. Hashtag create mish. A road traffic accident between a moped and a van. Let's see what it is. Hey, thanks, Andy. Okay, we're going out to the east this time. We're going out past Gravesend. We're going to a little town called Lodge Hill, near Chattenden, I believe it's pronounced. Probably said that wrong. So I'll show you where we're going on the map. So here we are in the centre of the city of London. We're heading out to Chattenden, which is out here. We're actually landing in this, not sure if it's a military area or something like that, but it's boxed off as if it's a no-fly zone. Unfortunately, I need to fly in there. So it should just be north of somewhere called Medway. Just waiting on the terrain, the map loading up here. So basically, we're just going to fly along the Thames eastbound, until we get to Gravesend is a shithole, says Jaguar. Alright, there's Chatham. Where is it we're going? Not Faversham. It is north of Rochester. There's Rochester there. That's there we are there. There's Lodge Hill. So we're going into here. Just to the east of Cliff Woods. And the incident we're responding to is right inside this no-fly zone area. I don't know why this is restricted airspace. I'm sure we'll find out as we get there. Hey, what's up, Squash, you fucking buster? Good to see you, big dog. Welcome. Yeah, get online, son. Get online. That would be awesome. We already had young Gatwick Tower providing some ATC services, but he had to get off because he was flying at the same time. Wouldn't mind a little professional squash action. Agent Squash has joined us on YouTube, guys. A very talented air traffic controller on VATSIM. He runs a great stream on Twitch. So if you get yourself onto Twitch, make sure you follow Agent Squash. Alright, the incident we're responding to is right on this junction, guys. Right here, on this little junction here, is where the incident is. So, not too far to go. It shouldn't take us long to get there. And we're responding to a road traffic collision. A woman has sustained life-threatening injuries in a collision with a bus. Oh, sorry, this one doesn't work, actually. I'm going to have to cancel this one. Sorry, bros. A dog attack! Let's see where this one is. Oh, this one's actually out towards Heathrow. Yeah, it's just to the northwest of Slough. It's in Maidenhead. So we're now going to Maidenhead, which is just to the west of our position. It's just west of London Heathrow. So we're going to be routing westbound on Hotel 4. We're going to join Hotel 10. And from Hotel 10, we're going to go up over Gunnersby Park, up past Ealing, westbound towards RAF Norfolk. Then from RAF Norfolk, we'll go to Uxbridge. From Uxbridge, we'll go down to Iver. And from Iver, we start heading out to Cookham, which should be just here. We'll be leaving controlled airspace at Cookham. And then we'll be routing southbound down towards Maidenhead, and we'll be landing somewhere around about here in Maidenhead, guys. So it's a dog attack that we're responding to. It's an urban incident. A young girl has been viciously attacked in her garden by a neighbour's dog and sustained major facial injuries. Who writes this stuff, man? This is brilliant. The first responder has just arrived on scene and has requested an immediate air ambulance to get the girl to the trauma room as fast as possible. A ground ambulance is also on the way and will stabilise the patient and will get her ready to fly. We just need to get there as quickly as we can. Roger that. I'm going to accept the mission. I'm going to quickly run to the toilet, guys, and I will be right back. We'll get on our way. What's up, Rory? Do I ever stream the live Lifeline flights in America? I haven't done it so far, brother. I might do it in future, though, maybe. Before I go, I'll give you guys something to look at. Thank you. Thanks, Squash. Rusty says, hey dude, you got any ideas why my helicopter rescue man plugin keeps writing flight plans in the wrong ARAC? I've updated it and it shows. I have no idea, Rusty. Sorry, bro. I wish I could help, dude. I have no idea. Why it keeps writing flight plans in the wrong ARAC? Well, it's the HRM just basically shows you where the incident is. It doesn't really write you a flight plan. If you join the Discord group, Rusty, join the charityscenery.co.uk Discord group, my friend, and post in the support section. We'll try and get you some help. Alright, Young Squash is online, 132.7. Information Kilo is current at London City. The current QNH is 1001. We already have 1001 set. Thames Director, a very good afternoon. Helimed 27 Alpha.
Helimed 27 Alpha, Thames Director, pass your details.
Squashy Poos! Very good to see you, sir. Helimed 27 Alpha, we're with you on the Royal London Helipad. We are a Bell 222 with Information Kilo from London City 1001. We're responding to an alpha call to in Maidenhead. We'd like to enter controlled airspace westbound on Hotel 4, routing for Hotel 10, leaving controlled airspace at Cookham with a basic service.
Helimed 27 Alpha, roger, clear to enter the city control site, routing Hotel 4 to Vauxhall Bridge. Sun's operating altitude and
I don't fly in real life, brother, no. Okay, clear to enter the city control zone westbound on Hotel 4 to Vauxhall Bridge, the squawk 7030 for 27 Alpha.
Helimed 27 Alpha, correct. Right, right, Golf Bravo Yankee speed 210 knots.
Alright.
Speed 210, Golf Bravo Yankee. And Golf Bravo Yankee, just to let you know, the procedure you're following has published speed restrictions. Wilco Golf Bravo Yankee.
Okay, roar RPM's coming up to 100%.
Fire 46 Papa, report your indicated airspeed.
250 knots, fly 46 Papa.
Checked, alright, we'll go for 102% now.
Speed 210 knots.
210, fly 46 Papa.
Engine RPM's beeped up to 102%. We are good, master warning panel's clear. We're clear on the left, we are clear on the right. The trim has been reset. We have accepted the mission. We have 35 minutes to get there. Our clearance ends at Vauxhall Bridge. Nose wheel up. Take the right wheel off the ground first. Stabilise any ground effect. We'll pop the nose any wind now.
Helimed 27 Alpha, report ready to lift.
Helimed 27 Alpha, we're lifting now.
Helimed 27 Alpha, roger, report Vauxhall Bridge.
27 Alpha. Okay, power's good, engine RPM is good.
Flyer 46 Papa Rosemo, navigation director Ravna, Kristen Ravsa. Descend to altitude 6,000 feet, the city QNH 1001.
Okay, stick forward, pedal left.
6,000 feet, QNH 1001. Gear up. Direct Ravsa, navigation.
Get my right pedal in here. We are transitioning through ETL now. Engine RPM back, sorry, rotor RPM back to 100%. Start trimming, start winning. Gears up, power's good. 7030 is set, we're squawking 1 Charlie. Andy's asking on YouTube, is TrackIR easy to set up? Yes, brother. It's pretty straightforward, my friend. There's lots of tutorials on YouTube to help you set it up, though, Andy, if you get a little bit lost with it.
Hotel 10, Cookham. Standard operating altitude.
Hotel 4, Barnes, Hotel 10, Cook, I'm standing operating altitudes VFR for Element 27 Alpha.
Element 27 Alpha, correct. Just report box
operating. 27 Alpha. G-Force game ready driver is available. Fuck off. Would I recommend TrackIR over VR? Asks Simley. No comment. I don't own VR, sir, so. I don't think it's very fair for me to make a comparison like that. I don't have enough experience with VR. Element 27 Alpha, Vauxhall Bridge.
Element 27 Alpha, Roger, report Barnes.
27 Alpha, welcome. Looks like it's turning into a lovely afternoon here. Clouds have cleared. Recommend full up clear of clouds. Passing over Chelsea Bridge. We're a little bit lower than we should be, so I'm just going to climb a little bit. What's up, Coxie, you fucking buster? Good to see you, mate. Well, that's not true, Coxie, but you know what I mean. You know what I mean, Coxie. Hope you're well.
Call Bravo Yankee, maintain altitude 6,000 feet until instructed. Maintaining 6,000, call Bravo Yankee.
Here's a London heliport coming up on the left-hand side. You can get this from charityscenery.co.uk, guys. I'm doing very well, Cocktail. Thanks, bro. Had a good positive day so far. Got loads done. Hit the gym this morning. Got back, started living a dream on the stream. Done a bit of cardio as well this morning. Just started on a cardio fucking train yesterday. I already hate it. But I'm going to keep going. Waiting for this guy to read back. Element 27 Alpha Barnes for Hotel 10.
Element 27 Alpha, Roger, report 9.
Element 27 Alpha.
546 Papa, 10 Lasting 270 degrees.
270, sir, got a problem with the FMC.
Go Bravo Yankee, speed 180.
Speed 180, go Bravo Yankee.
navigation direct at 10.
You don't need a treadmill, Coxie. You just need to fucking start running, bro. Just hit the streets. You don't need to spend money to get fit, brother. Keep it above 500R. Hey, Gassius, you got your stick and throttle working. Nice, dude. Hope you have as much fun as I do. Alright, just passed over... What's it called? Q Bridge. That's right, Q Bridge. We're now heading over Gunnersby Park, which is just in front of us. A laudable warning you can hear, it's just the aircraft telling me that I've got a little bit too much collective on. So Ealing is just coming up on the left hand side. We pass Ealing up towards Perryville. At Perryville we start routing westbound towards RAF Norfolk. Shout out to my main man Shifty Mover, who used to be based there. I got an autopilot in there and help me out. Boop. Okay, that's Perryville there. This is the road that we follow. This one here. We've overshot horribly. Never mind. Hey, what's up, Kyle, you fucking buster? I wish I could say I was happy to see you, Kyle. Just squeezing in a quick Hems flight before I go to work. If I get back from work early enough, dude, I'll probably jump on. Obviously, I know my service as the greatest helicopter pilot in the world, as you well know, Kyle, my services are greatly required. I hope you're well, young man. Squash says, I love Thames, there's no vectoring. Is this a lazy controller's position, is it? Hey, Andy, welcome on. Andy Jean-Pierre. Fantastic name, Andy. Good afternoon, brother. Just logged on. Where are you flying to? We're responding to an alpha call in Maidenhead, my friend. A young girl has been viciously attacked in her garden by a neighbour's dog. And sustained major facial injuries. The first responder has just arrived on scene and has requested an air ambulance to come and get her. So it's not all about road traffic collisions here in the Hems streams, brother. We're actually responding to a dog attack. Mickey used to be based at RAF Norfolk too. Nice, brother, with the EOD. What's the EOD, bro? Talk to me. Get to know me. Here's RAF Norfolk just coming up on the right hand side. Oh. I think the dog's already been put down, Coxie. We might even see the dog when we get to scene. How cool would that be, guys? If the guy that made the mod actually put in a dog at the scene. How cool would that be? Surely that would be worth donating some money to charity for, guys. Come on. Oh, I stay left here. Oh, explosive ordnance disposal. Roger that, Mickey. Thanks, man. Andy came in with it as well. Scott says they make the bombs go away. Thanks, Scott. Okay, Young Squashington has asked us to report Ivor. So we're heading for Gutteridge.
Clear to land runway 27, Golf Bravo Yankee.
Just passing Uxbridge, yep. We should start coming left now for Ivor. Ivor Heath. My man Bad Deer says, if bitten by a sausage dog, it would be fun and worth an extra donation. I don't think it's a sausage dog, bro. I think it's probably one of those fucking scumbag pit bulls or Staffordshire Terriers. Hey, Zocco, welcome. The Atomic Waffle says, what's up, Mav? Everything going well? I live the dream every day, sir. Thank you. I got to do my Russian homework, but I dig the stream. Thank you very much, my man. I'm glad you're enjoying it. Thames Director, Helimed 27 Alpha. We're just leaving Ivor Heath at this time, sir. We'd like to route direct for Maidenhead. Leaving Ivor on track, Maidenhead, Helimed 27 Alpha. MacVision says, I blame the owner, Sodia. Yeah, you're right, Coxie, it's not the dog. It's, you're right, dude, I take that back. I take that back. Those dogs are okay, it's the fucking owners that are scumbags. My man Andy says, I'm in the USAF and I've been to RAF Mildenhall. Have you tried landing there in game? I have landed there in game many years ago, Andy. I used to be a member of the Virtual Royal Air Force and I flew the C-17 Globemaster for thousands and thousands of hours. Yeah, I used to fly the C-17 in and out of Mildenhall quite a lot, my friend. What is it you do in the USAF, my friend? Too many friends in that sentence, Andy. Sorry, bro. Adam Smith would love a pug dog.
Oh, hell no.
No. No, sir. I say to you, no, sir. There's only three types of acceptable dogs, guys. Three types. Right at the very top are sheepdogs. So border collies. That's number one. Number two.
Taxi
Wait on my computer loading, guys. Fuck's sake. Hurry up. Right, so my computer's loading. Number one is a border collie. Fuck off, Coxie. Number one is a border collie, sheepdogs, alright? Number two is the Golden Labrador. In fact, there's four, actually, guys, four. Number three is a German Shepherd, an Alsatian. And number four is a West Highland Terrier, a little Scotty dog. Those are the only four acceptable dogs. Ah, five would be a little Jack Russell. A wee Jack. All the rest of them should be killed, guys. All the rest of them should be fucking killed. Big dogs all the way, exactly, Andy. I don't like Great Danes or anything like that, but yeah. Sheepdogs, Golden Labradors, and Alsatians, aka German Shepherds, they're all good in my book. If you want to get a, if you want to get a small dog, though, there's only two acceptable small dogs. A West Highland Terrier, aka a Scotty dog, and a Jack Russell. All the rest of them should be killed, guys. Oh shit, I forgot about Huskies! Sorry, guys, Huskies and Malamutes! Sorry, I forgot about those as well. There's quite a few acceptable dogs, guys, sorry. Right, we're over Maidenhead. This scene should be just down here on the right-hand side. So, there it's there! I flew right past it! There it's there. Looks like there's lots of space to land in there. Let's get the aircraft down. Alright, gear down. We'll take a quick orbit around, getting the aircraft a little bit too low here, bro. Trim reset now. See lots of flashing lights there. Doesn't look like there's any high tension power lines or cables, anything like that. We'll take a quick orbit just to look for obstacles and then we'll come around and land. The wind is 256 at 14 knots. So we'll be coming in from this direction. Looks like we're probably going to be landing on the road. Near where that van is. There's a lot of poles down there. A lot of lamp posts and street lighting posts. I think we'll land in the grass area, guys. We'll land in there instead of the road. Okay, the gear is down. We are below 90 knots. I'll take the rotor RPM up to 102% now. 102% is checked. Trim has been reset. Okay, the wind is 256, 15 knots now. Power's good. Rotor RPM is set. Okay, knows there's any wind here. Go start crabbing right. Thames Director, Helimed 27 Alpha. We're arriving on scene at Maidenhead and we are landing now. We'll call you for departure.
Helimed 27 Alpha, roger.
Speedbird 27 Alpha. Okay, power's good, road RPM is good, the gear is down. Three greens, I can see it. I see these poles on the junction. I see the pole to the right of the junction. See the emergency crew down there. Gonna try not to get too close. No rush to do this. Vertical speed's good, forward trend is good, power's good. Keep the forward trend coming. Power is good. Okay, we're clear of the poles on the left. We can start coming down now. Careful with the VRS envelope here. Forward trend. Alright, don't go any further forward. Let's just start coming down now. Stabilize any ground effect. And land the aircraft. Touching down. Nose wheel down. Gently lower the collector, center the cyclic and the pedals. Beep the engines down. Idle stop selected. Oh, look, guys, surprise, surprise! It's a fucking pit bull. There's a little girl on the stretcher, look. There's her mum. There's a police officer standing over the dog that's been shot, and rightly so. The girl's despawned, which means she's in the aircraft. The patient is sedated and on board. We are ready to lift for the trauma room. She is in very bad shape and urgently needs surgery. We are ready to go right away. Roger that. Right, okay, we've got to be careful on the Category Alpha departure here because we have trees right behind us on the right. We have poles right behind us on the left. So I think we're going to go out to the... We're going to go out to the right instead of the way we came in. So we're going to lift and we're going to come back and we're going to go out that way. That way, if we have an engine failure, we can auto-rotate back into here. Okay, Roar RPM is building. Okay, we have 100%. Take 102%. Checked. Trims reset. We're good on the left, we are good on the right. Temps Director, Element 27 Alpha, we're ready to lift from Maidenhead. We'd like to enter controlled airspace on track for the Royal London, routing eastbound on Hotel 10 to join Hotel 4 for the Royal London Hospital.
Hotel, Element 27 Alpha, roger, they're clear to enter the London control zone on track from Maidenhead Hill, then route Hotel 10 to Barnes, Hotel 4 to Royal London.
Hotel 10, Barnes, Hotel 4 for Royal London. Helimed 27 Alpha, we're lifting now.
Helimed 27 Alpha, roger, report Pumpkin Hill.
Helimed 27 Alpha.
Yes, I am using that, because it's Pumpkin Hill.
Alright, nose wheel up. Stable. Take the right wheel off the ground first. Stabilise any ground effect. Bring the nose into wind. And remember that that tree is quite close behind us, so I'm going to come up. I'm going to start coming up first before I go back. We'll come up. And we can come back now, nice and safe. Power's good. Rotor RPM is good. Clear of the trees. Feet, power's good. We'll come around to the right. In fact, we'll come around to the left, actually. Stick forward, pedal left. Collective off. Stick left now. Bring that round. Keep that coming. Looking good. Gear up. Free ETL, Rotor RPM back to 100%. Checked. Start trimming. Patient comfort score still 40 out of 40, guys. I got better transition than fucking Caitlyn Jenner. Okay, looking good, feeling good. Altitude hold, get the autopilot in to dial in the heading as well. Set. Right, where's this fucking hill he's talking about? Thames Director, Helimed 27 Alpha, we're airborne and routing for Ivor Heath at this time. Not sure where this hill VRP is you were talking about.
Pumpkin Hill, it's on the Helimed route, but it's alright, we can't
either. Yeah, I don't see it on the chart, Helimed 27 Alpha. Pumpkin Hill. No idea where that is, bro. Hey, Extreme, it's Payware, bro. This is the CowanSim Bell 222. What's the VRS like in this map if you look at the MIA the wrong way and VRS at DCS? As long as you stay outside the VRS envelope, bro, you'll be okay. You only get in trouble with VRS and helicopters if you descend at more than 500 feet per minute with like an airspeed of lower than like 20 or 15 knots. So as long as you stay out of the VRS envelope, brother, you'll be fine. But it will bite you in the ass if you go inside the VRS envelope, you have to react very quickly to get out of it. Oh! My man Albo just seems back. I love this guy. Welcome back, my Iraqi friend. Good to see you, sir. Greetings from Scotland, my friend. Salam alaikum. Oh shit, I fucked up. Is it salam alaikum? Sorry, I apologise if I didn't say that right, sir. Sorry. Thank you so much for another donation, my friend. Thank you so much, bro. I hope you enjoy watching. Salam alaikum. I think that's how you say it. I'm not sure, though. Isaac, the helicopter plugin's called the it's called the UK Air Ambulance mod. You can get it from the charityscenery.co.uk website. He said the Pumpkin Hill VRP, Dave. No idea where that is, brother. It's definitely not on the heli chart. Have I been playing Arma today? I haven't, brother. No, I might play Arma later on tonight once I've been to work. I was playing Arma last night. I start work at 4:30. So I start working 2 hours. And then if I get home from work early enough, my friend, I'll maybe fly later on tonight. Pumpkin Hill VRP is north of the Bravo Uniform Romeo NDB and northwest of Heathrow on the chart. It's not on the heli route chart. Yeah, you're not looking at the heli route chart though, are you? Or maybe you are, I've got a different one. I've got the Nats one. Show you which one I've got. This is the Nats, the chart from Nats. I don't see no Pumpkin Hill, bro. There's BUR. So it should be up there somewhere. Ah, same chart, but I missed it. I'll need to try and see if I can get an updated one then, bro. Maybe the chart's been updated. A new chart came out December last year. Nice one, thanks guys. I did not know that. Okay, so we're on Hotel 4 right now. We're just about to join Hotel 10, which is just as the river bends to the left as we go past the football stadium. I believe it's Fulham. I'm not a football guy, so I don't really know. Element 27 Alpha Barnes for Hotel 4. Hotel 4 for Royal London, Element 27 Alpha.
Element 27 Alpha, correct report, Vauxhall Bridge.
27 Alpha. Do I use add-on scenery for London City, or is this default as Ghost? I have add-on scenery for the whole of the UK, Ghost. I use the Orbex True Earth add-on scenery.
Temp director, Ascot 010.
Oh, an Ascot call sign. One of our Royal Air Force brothers joining us. You need to tell them what kind of aircraft you're in and where you are, bro.
What's your actual flight and intended routing? Which temp director was that for Ascot 010? AFM Ascot 010, report your actual flight and intended routing. Roger, aircraft type is a TBM 9er, routing north to Erbil, and then off to Noeber. Roger, Ascot 010, squawk 6701. Squawk 6711.
LMN 27 Alpha Vauxhall Bridge.
LMN 27 Alpha, Roger, report the heli for Christian, report the hospital. I've got 010, route east and remain outside controlled airspace.
Roger, turning.
Okay, there's a hospital there on the left hand side. Alright, gear's coming down. Mr. Albo just with another donation! God damn it, sir! Your generosity knows no bounds, my friend. Thank you so much. My man's donated like $40,000 so far. Thank you so much, brother. Element 27 Alpha, Roger, we'll keep an eye out. Okay, 260 at 14 knots. Rotor RPM is set to 102%. Trim has been reset, the gear is down 3 grains, I see it. Good visual on the hospital. Keep this nose this left pedal in, we'll get the nose into wind. LMN 27 Alpha, many thanks. See you next time, sir. Thank you. Okay, power's good, rotor RPM's good, the gear's down 3 greens, approach is good, rate of descent is right on the limit here at 500 feet. Careful with the VRS envelope as we get slower. Good visual on the trauma team. We start squaring up onto the pad now. settle any ground effect. Stabilize. And land the aircraft. There we go. Main gear's down, we get the nose wheel down, brakes are on. Gently lower the collective cyclic and pedal can go neutral. Welcome to the Royal London Hospital, guys. My man Jerky, that's a goddamn professional hoverland. You know it, bro. Greatest in the world. The greatest in the goddamn world, sir. Thank you. Shut these down. Thanks, Greg. What's my preference? Arma, X-Plane, or DCS? I like them all, dude. I like flying on Arma just for the lack of realism. I like flying on X-Plane and DCS for realism. So, yeah. I don't really have a preference one over the other. Alright, let's get these fuel pumps off. Fuel valve for two. Fuel valve for one. The hydraulics can go. The generator for two and one inverter for two and one can go as well. And collision and position lights can go. And the rotor is stopping. We'll get the rotor brake on. Rotor brake is set. Turn the transponder off. Checked. Alright, just the battery now. Boop. Welcome to the Royal London Hospital, guys. Thank you so much for joining me. I hope you enjoyed it. Please do me a massive favour and check out charityscenery.co.uk, guys. If you feel like being generous, you can donate even like £1 or $1 or €1, whatever it is, wherever it is you are in the world, guys. All the money raised goes to charity and we really are doing good things, helping to save people in real life as well as save people in the game as well. So if you enjoyed the mod, you can get that from charityscenery.co.uk as well. You can also buy this scenery here for the Royal London Hospital. You can also get that from the website as well. So yeah, make sure you check it out, guys. Make sure you check that out. Thank you so much for joining me, all the guys on Twitch. Massive shout out to my main man, Mr. Albo Jassim. Thank you so much for the two very generous donations, sir. Thanks to all the new followers that have joined us on Twitch. Thanks to all the new subscribers that joined us on YouTube. Thanks for the Captain's Club members joining us. Stream in, stream out. Thank you so much for your support, guys. I am going to go and make some food, jump out in the street, punch an old lady in the face, and then get myself to work. So I will see you guys for the next stream. It might be tonight if I get home from work early enough. If not, I will see you guys tomorrow at some point. Top Gun and Volleyball, ladies and gentlemen. I am not Scott Manley. Fly safe.